Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome back to our English class. This is Mam Yuni. How are you today? I hope all of you in a good condition. Stay at home always and stay happy and stay healthy, right? Okay, Assalamualaikum. Apa kabar anak-anak? Jumpa kembali dengan saya, Mam Yuni, di hari Kamis kelas Bahasa Inggris, ya. Kali ini kita akan mempelajari tentang narrative text yang keempat. Okay, are you ready now? Very good. Yeah, please open your book in 9. Okay, coba dibuka dulu bab ke-9-nya. Kemarin kita masih mempelajari tentang narrative text, bukan? Ya, sekarang ada sebuah cerita yang berasal dari negara Vietnam, ya. Untuk mereka, cerita ini merupakan folk tale atau cerita rakyat dari daerah Vietnam, ya. Tapi untuk kita ini merupakan cerita dari luar negeri, ya. Oke, sebelum kita masuk ke cerita, saya ingin mengemukakan learning objective-nya dulu, ya. Objective learning-nya, tujuan pembelajarannya adalah to listen the story, to read the story for myself, to read the story to other people, to get a moral lesson from a story, ya. Jadi masih sama seperti kemarin, mendengarkan cerita, membaca cerita untuk diri sendiri, membaca cerita untuk orang lain, dan mendapatkan pesan moral dari cerita tersebut. Oke? Ya. Nah, sekarang kita akan mempelajari tentang seperti apa folktale. Folktale itu is one kind of story. Merupakan salah satu jenis cerita. Basically, ya, dan pada dasarnya, there are three parts of story. Ada tiga bagian dari sebuah cerita folktale. Yang pertama, the first part sets the scene and introduces the character. Jadi bagian pertama adalah menceritakan tentang latar belakang dan memperkenalkan karakter-karakternya. Yang kedua, the second part, main characters faces a problem. Ya, jadi untuk bagian kedua adalah merupakan karakter utama, ya, yang mengemukakan sebuah masalah, ya, masih sama seperti kemarin, ada introduction, kemudian number two is complication, right, masalah, dan yang ketiga, in the third part, the problems is a resolved atau resolution. For better or for worse. Jadi yang bagian ketiga adalah masalah yang dipecahkan, ya. Bisa jadi masalah itu menjadi lebih baik atau menjadi lebih buruk. Ya, kalau menjadi lebih baik artinya happy ending, tapi kalau lebih buruk menjadi sad ending, ya. A folk tale with one or two characters and with a simple problem is usually short. Jadi dalam sebuah cerita rakyat, satu atau dua karakter dengan masalah yang sederhana, ya. Biasanya ceritanya pendek, tidak panjang, ya. But with more characters and more complex problems, the structure is more complete, ya. Tapi untuk karakter yang lebih atau masalah yang lebih lagi, ya, maka strukturnya akan lebih kompleks lagi, ya. Oke, susunannya. Oke. Ya. Ya. Nah, di sini saya punya sebuah cerita, ya, ada di buku kalian. Coba kalian perhatikan The Golden Starfruit Tree, ya. Judulnya The Golden Starfruit Tree. Okay. Watch the video on link. This is Pay close attention how to read the story correctly and clearly. Jadi kamu perhatikan dengan baik ceritanya, ya, supaya kamu bisa membacanya.
Nice to see you again.
Dengan baik pronunciation.
Today we are going to learn about narrative text.
Okay.
The purpose is to get a moral lesson from a folk tale. The golden star fruit tree. A long time ago, there was a rich old man living in Vietnam. He had two sons. They had very different attitudes. The older brother was very greedy. But the younger brother was very kind. When the old man died, the brothers divided his father's wealth into two parts.
The big brother took almost everything. He gave his younger brother only a small piece of land, with a star fruit tree in front of it.
The younger brother did not mind. From then on, he lived there and made his living only by selling star fruits from the tree.
Unfortunately, a very big raven often came and ate all the ripe fruits. At first, he was too afraid of the raven and did not know what to do. One day he dared to approach the raven. He begged to it not to eat the fruits.
If you eat the fruits, I will have nothing to sell to the market and my family will starve.
Surprisingly, the raven was not angry. He replied,
I need the fruits too. Can I have them and I'll pay you with gold? Bring a 1 meter long bag, and I'll bring to a place full of gold and you can fill the bag full with gold.
The younger brother then told his wife to make a 1 meter long bag. When the bag was done, he climbed on the raven's back and they flew to a place full of gold. He filled the bag full with gold and then flew back home on the raven's back. From then on, the younger brother and his family could live happily in luxury. On the commemoration of his father's death, he invited his older brother to come to his house. Thinking that his brother had a poor house, the big brother refused to come. But because his younger brother insisted, he and his wife finally decided to come. When they got to the younger brother's house, they were surprised to see that he was now very rich. He asked his younger brother how he had got all his wealth, and the younger brother was happy to tell him the truth.
Then, the greedy brother and his wife offered the younger brother to trade all their fortune for the star fruit tree. The younger brother gladly accepted the offer.
Soon the older brother and his family moved to the house with the star fruit tree. When the raven came for the star fruits, the older brother made the same plea. As expected, the raven told him to bring a 1 meter long bag. Because he was greedy, he asked his wife to make a much longer bag. When the bag was done, he climbed on the raven's back. And then they flew to the place full of gold. He filled the big bag with gold. He also brought some gold in his pockets. On the way home, the load soon became too heavy for the raven. Unable to hang on, the raven swayed, and the greedy brother fell straight down to the sea with his bag and pockets full of gold. Knowing that his older brother sank into the sea, the younger brother and the people in the village tried to search, and finally could save him. The older brother said that he was sorry for being so greedy, and that he had learned his lesson.
Okay, sampai di sini dulu. Untuk kelanjutannya adalah latihan cerita True and False. Kalian bisa melihatnya lebih lanjut. Okay? Nah, cerita tadi sama persis seperti yang tertulis di buku cetakmu. Nah, untuk itu kalian perhatikan bagaimana pronunciation-nya, pengucapannya, correctly and clearly, right? Nah, lalu kamu mencoba menyalakan kembali, turn on again, okay, this video, di-style kembali videonya, dan belajar membaca. Ketika narator membaca pertama kali, kalian coba ulangi untuk kedua kalinya, okay? Nah, caranya seperti itu. Ya, kita lihat lagi selanjutnya. Nah, ini adalah kutipan cerita yang ada di buku kamu. Kamu boleh lihat di halaman chapter 9. Ya. Okay, saya baca ya. Nanti kalian dengarkan. Okay, kalau tadi versi bahasa Inggrisnya, nah ini versi lafaz of pronunciation Indonesia. Ya. The Golden Star Fruit Tree. A long time ago, there was a rich old man living in Vietnam. He had two sons. They had very different attitudes. The older brother was very greedy, and the younger brother was very kind. When the old man died, the brothers divided his father's wealth into two parts. The big brother took almost everything. He gave his younger brother only a small piece of land with a star fruit tree in front of it. The younger brother didn't mind it. From then on, he lived there and made his living only by selling star fruits from the tree. Unfortunately, a very big raven often came and ate all the ripe fruits. At first, he was too afraid of the raven and didn't know what to do. But one day, he dared to approach the raven. He begged to eat, not to eat the fruits. If you eat the fruits, I will have nothing to sell to the market and my family will starve. Surprisingly, the raven was not angry. He replied, I need the fruits too. Can I have them? And I'll pay you with gold. Bring a 1 meter long bag, and I'll bring 2 plates full of gold. And you can fill the bag full with gold. The younger brother then told his wife to make a 1 meter long bag. When the bag was done, he climbed on the raven's back, and they flew to a place full of gold. He filled the bag full with gold and then fly back home on the raven's back. From then on, the younger brother and his family could live happily in luxury. On the commemoration of his father's death, he invited his older brother to come to his house. Thinking that his brother had a poor house, the big brother refused to come. But because his younger brother insisted, he and his wife finally decided to come. When they got to the younger brother's house, they were surprised to see that he was now very rich. He asked his younger brother how he had got all his wealth, and the younger brother was happy to tell him the truth. Then the greedy brother and his wife offered the younger brother to trade all their fortune for the star fruit tree. The younger brother gladly accepted the offer. Soon the older brother and his family moved to the house with the star fruit tree. When the raven came for the star fruits, the older brother made the same plea. As accepted, the raven told him to bring a 1 meter long bag. Because he was greedy, he asked his wife to make a much longer bag. When the bag was done, he climbed on the raven's back, and then they flew to the place full of gold. He filled the big bag with the gold. He also brought some gold in his pocket. On the way home, the load soon became too heavy for the raven, unable to hang on. The raven swayed, and the greedy brother fell straight down to sea with his bag and pocket full of gold. He sank very fast down to the sea. The older brother finally died. He died because of his greedy. Okay, that's all. Ternyata endingnya beda ya. Kalau di cerita video, endingnya adalah happy, right? The ending is happy. Jadi, the younger brother came to help his older brother. Ya, his old brother. Jadi, kalau yang di cerita video, si adik yang muda, yang si adik bungsu datang untuk menolong kakaknya, ya. Dan si kakak merasa menyesal. Tapi kalau di cerita di buku, di sini diceritakan bahwa sad ending, ya, endingnya is sad, right? Bahwa kakaknya meninggal, ya. Meninggal karena kerakusannya, ya. Okay. Tidak apa-apa. Versi ceritanya kadang berbeda-beda dan kalian tidak usah bingung, ya. Kalian boleh menggunakan versi yang ini atau versi yang di video. Tapi saya sarankan, gunakanlah versi yang pada buku, karena kalian bisa baca. Right? Okay? Nah, selanjutnya, okay, exercise-nya. Yang pertama, record your reading the golden star fruit tree correctly and clearly on video. Ya, yang pertama adalah kamu harus merekam bacaan ceritamu the golden star fruit the correctly and clearly on video. Jadi, caranya kamu videokan, kamu rekam ya dengan video baca sambil megang buku dengan pronunciation yang bagus, ya. Boleh mengikuti seperti pronunciation saya. Jadi, cara bacanya titik koma diperhatikan. Oke, kemudian setelah itu, record your finding on video with the heading sentences to introduce the scene and character are. Jadi, sebelum kamu membuat video, kamu cari dulu the sentences-nya, ya. Kalimat yang memperkenalkan tentang latar belakang dan karakter-karakternya. Yang mana aja, ya. Makanya kamu baca dulu dengan baik, pahami dulu ceritanya, dan makna artinya yang tidak kamu ketahui, kamu boleh consult, ya. Kamu boleh berkonsultasi, cari tahu dengan melalui kamus atau Google Translate, ya. Oke, jadi saya mau nanti setelah kamu bercerita, the sentences to introduce the scene and character are, oke, misalnya, di slide sebelumnya, oke, nah, misalnya yang mana nih, yang introduces-nya, oke, kamu bisa lihat kan? Ya, a long time ago, there was a rich old man living in the Vietnam. He had two sons. Okay, they had very different attitudes. The older brother was very greedy, and the younger brothers was very kind. Terus, okay. Dan yang mana lagi karakternya? Ada karakternya ya, selain dua orang yang tadi. Dan satu bapak tua yang memiliki anak. Kamu cari tahu. Kemudian, oke. Okay, record to your finding on video with the heading resolve problem. Nah, resolution problemnya tuh yang mana? Biasanya letaknya ada di bagian akhir cerita. Ya? Oke. Okay. Jadi kalian tentukan yang mana introducing-nya, kemudian yang mana resolution problem-nya. Oke, okay? Problem-nya sudah tahu ya apa? Problem-nya adalah di mana seekor gagak memakan pohon belimbing emas. Oke, okay? Lalu problemnya adalah di situ, ya. Lalu menukarnya dengan emas. Gagaknya memakan buah-buahan dan menukarnya dengan emas. Tapi di sini dituntut kesabarannya. Apakah orang yang menukarnya emas menuruti kata-kata si gagak hanya 1 meter panjang tasnya? Atau lebih. Nah, masalahnya adalah kalau si adik si adik menuruti apa perkataan si gagak, ya. Dia membuat 1 meter tas, tapi beda halnya dengan kakaknya. Dia lebih. Jadi ketika emasnya dibawa oleh si adik sampai ke rumahnya dan dia menjadi kaya. Tapi kalau si kakak karena keberatan emas yang dia bawanya, akhirnya dia jatuh, ya, dan si gagak juga nggak bisa menahan, dia jatuh di tengah laut dan mati seketika karena kerakusannya, ya. Oke, jadi dipahami cerita dan artinya, ya. Record, ya. Kemudian resolve problemnya itu apa, ya? Kamu cari tahu di situ, ya. Sudah saya ceritakan tadi. Tapi try to find the sentence in English. Jadi cari tahu ceritanya dalam bahasa Inggris yang ada di cerita The Golden Star Fruit Tree-nya. Oke? Okay? Ya. Yeah. Caranya bikin video, ya, yeah, sesuai dengan step-step yang ada. Yang tadi saya ceritakan, yang pertama kamu baca dulu ceritanya, full cerita dengan pronunciation kamu. Gunakan pakaian sekolah ya, nak. Pakaian sekolah hari ini kamu gunakan untuk membuat video supaya saya tahu juga wajah kamu, ya. Okay. Setelah kamu baca video, baca ceritanya, boleh lihat buku. Kemudian kamu cari tahu introduce-nya, introducing-nya ya, yang pertama. Kalimat pembukanya itu maksudnya menceritakan latar belakangnya dan tokoh-tokohnya ya. Lalu yang ketiga, kamu cari tahu resolution-nya. Oke, okay? Resolution-nya ada yang happy ending, ada yang sad ending. Cari di situ yang mana resolution-nya. Oke. Okay? Setelah kamu bikin videonya, kan sudah saya buat ya cara mengucapkannya ya. Jadi kamu nanti bilang setelah kamu baca pertama yang ceritanya secara keseluruhan, lalu kamu bilang the sentences to introduce the sense and character are bla 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 and bla 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 bla. Oke. Okay? Kemudian the result problem in the golden star fruit tree is apa dan apa. Oke. Okay? Kemudian kamu buat videonya, lalu setelah video kamu buat, kamu kirimkan ke grup bahasa Inggris ya, as soon as possible. Send to your WA English group as soon as possible. Ya. Bagi anak-anakku yang belum mengerjakan tugas kemarin, tolong segera kerjakan dan kirim ke grup bahasa Inggrisnya masing-masing. Oke, okay, saya tunggu. Good luck and see you. And goodbye. Assalamualaikum.